Put request, update or replace existing resource by sending data to the server. Currently we are in section 5 and we are about to check out the third video of this section. Now in the previous video, we saw how to send data to the server using JSON format. And we used post request for that. So in this video, we are going to focus on how to send data to the server by using form URL encoded format. For that, we are going to use the put request. And this time, our URL will contain a path parameter such as an ID in the end. Now, you can also perform the put request using the JSON format. But since I want to show you how to send data to the server by using a new format, so let's check it out. So, our request body will appear to be somewhat like this. It will have a key value pair such as name and value, age and value, gender and value. And these key value pair will be separated with the help of ampersand. And the same data in terms of JSON will appear to be like this. So both are same, just that the format is different. Now for this format, the content type in the header will be application slash x www form URL encoded. Well, it will be taken care by retrofit internally, so don't worry about it. So within our node server, we already have a method that accepts the put request. This is our endpoint URL. Then in the request, we will receive a destination object. Then using the for loop, we will find out the destination that we want to update or replace. Thereafter, we will extract all the data. And then finally, we will replace the old destination by the new one and send the updated object back to the client. But in the HTTP response, we are sending it back in the form of JSON, not in the form of URL encoded. So make a note of that. So within my destination service, I will create a function that will of course return the call object of the type of destination. And this destination, we will receive it from the server, which will be the updated destination. Let us use the annotation of put. Define the endpoint URL as per our node server, which has the path parameter of ID. Now to enable our HTTP response to have a body of form URL encoded format, so here we have a special annotation for that, such as form URL encoded, of course. And within this function, you have to pass all the data that you want to include as a form URL encoded format. So I will use a comma and define the annotation of field with a key of, let's call it city. Define the variable. Let us format my parameters so as to make it more readable. Then define the field of description and also the country. So this completes our code. Now since we know that the field name or the key name of the path parameter should match with what we have defined here. Now similarly, the key that we have defined here, such as city, description and country, should match with what you have defined here as city, country and description. Make a note of that. Otherwise, your web service won't be able to map the resources from the incoming HTTP request. Once you are done, move to your destination detail activity, where we have the update button. So we need to replace these code by the retrofit code. Get the service. Get the request call. First, you have to pass the path parameter, which is currently ID. So I have to pass the first parameter as ID. Now as a second parameter, you have to pass city followed by description and then country. Once you are done, make a network call in the background by using the NQ function. Check for the success and also display a toast message here. Then display the success message and also move back to our list activity. And from the server, we are getting the updated destination object. If you want, you can extract it and then use it or ignore it. It's totally up to your wish. Before you run the application, make sure your server is up and running. And then run your application. Go to the list activity. Let us edit our New Delhi and change it to Old Delhi. Update it. So here we go, item was updated successfully and we are getting Old Delhi. If you look at our log, then you will find this is our put request, where in the header we have the content type as application slash form URL encoded. And as the body of the request, you will find something in the form of key value pair, such as city as Old Delhi, description as something. Then we have country as India. But in response, we are receiving the status code as 200 OK. Then we have some headers. Now as a body in the HTTP response, we are getting a JSON data. Well, that's okay. You can use any combination. In the request, we used form data, but in response, we are getting the JSON data. It doesn't matter. The only thing that you have to make sure is that your server should support the type of data that you are sending from the client to the server. And that's it. Now that we know how to create and update a resource, let us learn how to delete a resource.